surrounded by Bob Goldstein. Our guest, Rocky Colavito, the Cleveland Indians. Rocky, there have been many great moments in your baseball career, and many big ones still ahead, I know, but I'm sure one you'll always remember is the night of June 10th, 1959. In that game against the Baltimore Orioles, you have 4 home runs in 1 game to tie a major league record. I'd like to ask you about that game. Do you recall, as you went along, did you ever stop to think that that record might be in hand, or just might be your big night?
Well, Bob, that was the most wonderful night of my baseball career, and that's number one. And as far as recalling that with the baseball record, I have always known that 4 home runs was a baseball record in 1 game. But, you know, you go in the ballgame and you hit your first home run and you just let it get a base hit to go along with it. And then you hit the second home run, you feel the same way. And then on to the third. I hit the third and I just said, boy, this is my best night in the big leagues. And 3 home runs in 1 game. So if I just could get a base hit and have for a night, I'd be real happy. And then the second pitch, I hit the ball, and as soon as I hit it, it was up in there. And I could have jumped up around the base, and I felt so good about it. It was just the most wonderful tour I've ever had in baseball.
When you went up then the fourth time, there wasn't any real pressure to hit another one, right?
No, not sure. I figured I had a fairly good night, the 3 home runs. And if I just could get a base hit to make it that even 4-4, I'd be real happy. I wasn't going to be greedy about it.
Well, did they pitch you different every time?
Yeah. Are you referring to what the pitches were? Would you like to know that part?
Mm-hmm.
Well, the first pitch was a slider off Jerry Walker. The second pitch, I'm not sure, was a curveball slider, but I have the feeling it was a slider. And the first one was sort of down, and the second one was sort of up. The third pitch was a low fastball. I got a piece before it sunk. And a really tiny bit away. And the last pitch was a high inside fastball.
Mm-hmm. On that high inside fastball there, is that the one you usually hit pretty well for home run?
Well, Bob, I'm a funny sort of a hitter. When I'm hitting low, I might get good with a high inside fastball, and I might hit the low outside ball. It depends. When you're hitting low, I don't think there's any particular spot to me. I think some goes with the same goes when I'm hitting bad. I can get me out and just about anything.
Rocky, back in the early days, did you design to become an outfielder or a pitcher?
I wanted to be an outfielder. The reason is I want to play every day. Now, when I signed, as a pitcher outfielder. I thought that if I couldn't hit well with a string line, I'd go to pitching. But I always said I could hit a little bit, and I wanted the chance to see what I was going on.
You were born actually up at Yankee Stadium.
That's right, Bob. I was born 5 minutes from Yankee Stadium. And I spent a lot of ball games when I was young, and Yankees were always my ballpark at the end of
the year. Mm-hmm. I recall you telling me that it was your brothers that really helped to develop your arm, is that right?
Oh, yes. My brothers, they used to make me throw all the time, and like the story I once told you, throw a couple of times, they would think I had to throw the ball over. And I think that really well, and I think that has a right arm. But when I put him down, I think all the time he could work better.
Rocky, if you're ability to hit the long ball and pulling it to the left, have you noticed that the pitchers, for the most part, are working on you now in a certain way?
No problem. I've had that question put up to me quite often, and to tell you the truth, I don't think they're waiting for next year to try to alter anything that they think they're doing wrong. I mean, they're stop you. I think they're going to go right to it. What I mean by that is that you're getting a couple of hits off in the series, I think they're going to go right on and try to do something about it in that next ball game. I don't think they're going to work for next year.
Well, for example, they try to put you on the outside, knowing that if they get it inside, you can throw it into the seat.
No, I don't think so, Bob. I think some balls that are away from me at the ballpark. See, I think what they try to do is go in and out with me.
Mm-hmm.
I think that they try to set me up, maybe get something away and try to jam me, and then maybe if they think I'm thinking about getting jammed, they might try to go away from me. They try to keep you off balance, changes of speed and stuff like that.
Suppose they try to keep throwing that clear of breaking on the outside corner. That was going to be a tough one to hit.
Well, yes, Bob, I think that the pitcher has to be the hitter with the coat and vice versa. And I think that's been throwing out there all the time. I think I have done with the pitch, so I'm going to just try to go through a little bit more. Well, you got to get smart. I mean, you stand up there and be a gun, though, you're not going to get any place, so I try to do my best.
That's part of the deal, being able to think as well as throwing it out.
I think so. I think they have to try to figure it out, see if they're doing it.
How about your experience?
Down low. I had a pretty good year in Indianapolis hitting that way, and as soon as I got to Big League, without seeing much of me, they said, well, you can't hit that way in the Big League. And why, I don't know, but that's the funny thing. You have an odd stance to say you can't hit that way. So I've always been bad solid at that. So I went to a little open stance. Now I sort of close up just a little bit, but I don't stop hitting. And I like it when I work properly. What do you like to do for recreation when baseball is over or during the offseason? Oh, I just love to hunt. I always had,
So you're a combination mushroom picker and a home run hitter, a sneaky and all around good man.
Well, I try to be. I like to be.
Rocky Colavito, it certainly is a great pleasure to have you with us. And certainly, I believe that you've been rocking on for a while, and I may like to still have you, which I'm sure you're very good.
Thank you, Paul.
I really appreciate that. And now, folks, with the Bob Brooks sneaker over Rocky Colavito, here's something else I like you to say. Hi everybody, Bob Wolf speaking along with the third score of the Cleveland Indians. Third score is the roommate of Rocky Colavito, and Rocky is the roommate of third score looking the other way. If I guess you call it a fellow morning roommates, you're real close friends have been for many years.
And that's right, Bob. I think we're more like brothers than we are friends because we've been together a long time, and even during the time we stay pretty close together. It's a good relationship.
Hunter Rocky has just stepped in the battle stage, so you take over the microphone and tell our viewers a little about Rocky's batting style, okay?
Well, Rocky stands about midway back in the batting box. He has a rather cold stance, and he doesn't try quite as hard as he wants to, but probably it doesn't make him a better hitter. But you notice while he's swinging here in batting practice, that ball he just hit was outside him, and he just went right into the ball hit the right field. I think one of the things that has really helped Rocky is the ability to learn to wait on the ball, which most young ball players have tended to be anxious, and now with Rocky's following it. Now, if you'll notice, he has very quick hands, and that has really made him a better hitter, waiting on the ball. He now realizes that he has real quick hands, and that is why he's able to wait longer and hit that curveball better now. Rocky was always a real good fastball hitter, and he still is today. I venture to say that most of his home runs now come off the breaking ball because he sees more of them, and he just learned to hit them and wait on the ball. Right there is a good example. He hit that ball, I don't know how far, a long way, about 350, 360 feet. He hit a nice, easy right hand. There's another one that was way out over the plate, and he hit it to deep left center field. In fact, there's one of the seats out there. A real good hitter. One of the things I think about Rocky, and I think this is interesting to young ball players as well as anybody else. And determination and confidence, that's actually what made Rocky the hitter he is. 2 weeks ago, Rocky had a bad streak. He was 0 for 18. And I see him after the game, he come into the room and say, well, Rooney's is, I'll get him tomorrow. I've never seen Rocky discouraged or down. And that happens to all of them. I'm going to pretend to take this about Rooney. He's the optimist. Rocky will say back at the game, well, I'm going to. Well, I feel good today. I think I go through it. Also, well, I hope we win. And he more or less thinks he's going to do it. I just say to myself, I hope we can do it. Real good becoming a hit. Rocky has many different manners when he's seen in the batting circle or before he got the back stretching, or putting it back behind his head and stretching his muscles. And I think it's a real determined baseball player. So I think that's what made Rocky is determined.
In a different game, he could pack a wallet with his back. Baseball was a joy since he was a boy. On that diamond, he would hang his hat. He grew up in the Bronx, hearing those horn honks. But 42 home runs, he's number one. In hearts of those who cheer and cry. In the All-Star game, building up his fame, he can hit and run, throw and slide. In 1959, his renown would climb, home runs in consecutive at bats. For in all there were, so we all were sure, Cleveland had a hero, how about that? All the fans who saw it left the game wide-eyed. Someday they would wonder like us all. Rocky Colavito, where the heck did you go? We still have the memory of your baseball majesty. Rocky Colavito, you put on a big show. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Senior Vice President of Public Affairs for the Cleveland Indians, Bob DiBiasio.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Yes, the crowd make what I read. Thank you, thank you. Good afternoon, and welcome to a very special day here at Tony Brush Park in the Little Italy neighborhood of Cleveland. We gather today to celebrate a generational hero. We are here to show our respect and our love for a man who, for so many of us, helped shape our childhood. Mr. Rocco Domenico Colavito. I think we can all agree it was a little bit more simple. In the game of baseball, there was no designated hitter, no interleague play. There was no cable TV, the internet, and social media were far into the future. We enjoyed our icons in a few ways. By going to Cleveland Municipal Stadium, watching a rare game on television, listening to the ever-present transistor radio that we hid under our pillows so our parents would not hear us listening to Star Games. Hear the words of the baseball beat writers of our local newspapers, or a special glimpse that many of you had at a baseball card signing show at a local department store. One thing is for sure, we love our icons, and Rocky Colavito is at the top of that list. To get our ceremonies underway, I kindly ask that if you are able to please stand, remove your caps, as we welcome Cleveland's own Randy Austin in the singing of our national anthem. Oh, say can you see by the dawning light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose bright light and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets ring the monster singing air, gave through the night, that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave?
Thank you, Rainey. We have a number of special guests this afternoon to help celebrate this very exciting day. A man who considers Rocky and Sonny Siebert as two favorite Cleveland Indians players as a child, Indians owner Paul Dolan. A few friends and teammates of Rockies are with us today. Please welcome former Indians infielder Vern Fuller. We have a couple of Detroit Tiger teammates. Hey. You can clap for these Tiger teammates. Yeah. First, we welcome a gentleman who played 18 years in the big leagues, and in year 17, he played every single game and collected 180 hits. Mr. Willie Horton. And the last man to stand on the mound and win 30 games in the big leagues, Mr. Denny McClain. Thank you, gentlemen, for being here. Rocky, I want you to know that Terry Francona is heartbroken that he cannot be here with you today. And everyone here knows he just underwent hip surgery, and our therapists and rehab people said he's not allowed to be mobile. But he sends his love to you and truly wishes that he could be here with you today. So how did we get here today? We need to turn the calendar back to January of 2017, and if you remember that time, we were just a few months removed from Game 7 of extra innings of the World Series, which keeps us up at night, right? That's the things that keep us up at night. We were still bummed about that game, but I'm in my office and I get a phone call from a Buffalo News reporter by the name of Mark Summer, and Mark tells me that he was going to write a book about Rocky Colavito. A few weeks later, we're sitting in my office, and lo and behold, Rocky and Mark connect. And what comes of that is the terrific book with the perfect title. Cleveland's Iconic Slugger is written. Terrific book. Very great. You know, most writers would be okay with just writing a book. Mark thought, let's do something a little extra special. So at the 2019 Major League Baseball All-Star Game in Cleveland, where our town shined internationally, we had an event called an evening with Rocky Colavito at Playhouse Square. I'm sure many of you in attendance today were there that night on such a wonderful, wonderful evening. Mark's work made an impact on one lady, Ida Pochi. Ida is an incredible ball of energy and deep love for Rocky, as we all do, and her idea that he needed to be honored with a statue just kept pushing and pushing and pushing. So I know that Ida, where are you? Mark Summer, where are you? Come over here and just give these two an incredible round of applause. There's Mark. These are the two that have the incredible energy to make today truly special and make it happen. And of course, an event like today could not happen without strong leadership and the support of very many. Today does not happen without this gentleman in particular. His leadership, to say a few words, please welcome to the podium, Matt Gamatti. I can't believe it. I mean, this time now was a little thought in my head. They say you open your mouth, you put your foot in it. I opened my mouth, and this is what we got. Okay?
from the committee, I can't believe how much energy they put into it. Ida, of course, my secretary, right hand, telephone crazy person, Randy, Mark, Sheldon, wherever you are, Joe Gazzo, I'm glad I met Joe Gazzo, tremendous person. I just found that everybody that I talked to jumped on this thing, and here's it. Look what we got. Look what we got. We got wall-to-wall people. And it's for free. The name doesn't keep anybody up. Well, there's Sheldon. Sheldon. Okay. I just want to give everybody thanks, and I could not do this without the support of my committee and your cooperation. These bricks, if you come here, you're going to read them, and you're going to get a lump in your throat because of what they say. They are more available. We'll have forms for you, so don't miss out. We come here for eternity, these bricks. And enjoy this festivity. And I'm glad you were able to put it off. I thank you all. Thank you, Matt. Again, today does not happen without his strong leadership. And thank you for all of you on the committee for your teamwork. You know, teamwork is absolutely the bedrock of success. I would like to welcome to the podium another member of our team. Please welcome State Senator Jerry Serino. Thank you, Bobby. How about, let's give it up for my cousin, Matt Gavity. It is so great to be here. I grew up down here and went to school right across the street for kindergarten through eighth grade. And it was just wonderful experience being here. And it is such a privilege to be here today. I'm joined by my friend and colleague in the Ohio Senate, Sandra Williams. Sandra is the senator for this area. If you probably wouldn't mind if I mentioned that she's also a candidate for the mayor of the city of Cleveland. You'll hear more about that. And Senator Penny Yuko is here someplace. If Penny wants to come up, though, I'm not sure where he is. Penny's back there. He's raising his hand. Rocky, I was 9 or 10 years old when you hit those 4 home runs. Thank you. And at that age, everybody at that age wanted to be Rocky Colavito. You know that, right? And the contributions that you have made, not just to Cleveland sports and to the Indians particularly, but to the excitement that you gave so many young people who were playing baseball, who were never going to be in the major leagues, but you motivated all of us to play baseball and to watch baseball, listen to it on the radio, as a matter of fact, most of the time, because a lot of the games were not televised. And, you know, it is such a privilege for me to be here with you and Senator Williams, and to be able to honor you on your 88th birthday. And by the way, there are 88 counties in the state of Ohio, and we have 1 year for each county. And we know you're going to live a lot longer and enjoy many more birthdays as you should. What Senator Williams and Senator Yuko and I would like to present to you is an affirmation from the Ohio Senate. I won't read it because of time, but it recognizes the tremendous contributions that you have made to baseball, to the Cleveland Indians, and to the city of Cleveland. And we know that everybody in the Senate that we've talked to about this knows who Rocky Colavito is, even if they're from Southern Ohio. A couple of them we had to educate a little bit because they're too young to remember, but this is our way of saying thank you. It's a small token of our appreciation, but an important one from your Ohio State Legislature, particularly from the Senate,
recognizing the great contributions you have made to all of us here in Cleveland. Thank you very much. Thank you. One person we wanted to also recognize, Del Bobo. It's not a nickname. Del Bobo helped clean up the brush here at Tony Brush Park, and he actually planted 4 rose bushes in Rocky's honor for that night in June of 1959, where he hit 4 homers in a single game. So thank you, Del Bobo, here. Way to go, buddy. Thank you. Another member of our team who makes today possible, please welcome Cuyahoga County Council Representative for Ward 7, Councilwoman Yvonne Conwell.
I like to correct the district, though. Good afternoon, Rocky family and friends and fans. Yay! That's what we're here today. I'm Councilwoman Conwell from the county, and my colleague is here today, Councilman Gallagher, Councilwoman Cheryl Stevens, and myself. We sponsored this legislation to get what you're going to see today. And we salute Rocky on his efforts on the field and off the field. He has done an outstanding job for his community. Happy birthday, especially for me. But when you see this unveiled, you will know why he is being celebrated today. He is being celebrated because of the work that he has done, like I stated earlier, on the field and off the field. You know, that's an honor. He is above ground. He is with us today. That is a celebration. Most of us know we don't get those accolades until we're gone. So this is something to shout about, cheer about, that we are glad he's here to see.
Thank you, Yvonne, and again, thank you for all you did, and Mike Gallagher for all you did to get this day here. Appreciate it. Today also does not happen with all of you, the great fans of the Cleveland Indians and of Rocky Colavito. On behalf of all of you, we want to hear a few words from one of our main committee members, Joe Godzo.
Thank you, everybody. I'm gonna apologize in advance if I get a little emotional, but that's the way I am. It's the Italian in me, and I can't help that. But first of all, I'm honored to be up here to be able to speak on all of your behalf. You know, when the committee finally had put things together for the statue and everything came to fruition, what had happened was we received an outpouring of fans that was beyond belief. People were calling in to all the committee members. How could they partake? What could they do? How could we get involved? And what ended up being involved with all those conversations was a story about Rocky. All the fans had an individual story that they had to share. And there were two things in common that took place with every one of those conversations. Half of the conversations ended in tears, and all of the conversations ended in "How much they love Rocky." And I know that everybody standing here today could very easily be standing where I'm at right now, having your own Rocky Colavito story. I know that because we've heard countless stories. And Rocky, whether you were hitting a home run or whether you were throwing a bullet to third base from right field with a golden arm of yours, or whether you were simply sitting on the steps outside of the church signing autographs for kids, you made an impact on all of us, and we want you to know that. And I think what made it magical was the fact that while we embraced you, you embraced us. You made us feel special. And we'll never forget that. And I'll never forget the time when Randy Mintz and I were leaving your house on one of our visits. And there you were in the doorway waiting to die to us. And I looked at Randy and I said, "How can you not love Rocky?" And he looked at me and he instantly said, "Joe, Rocky is a fan of the fans. It's that simple. He's a fan of the fans." And no truer words were ever spoken. So today, when we unveil this masterpiece of David Demings for all the future generations to enjoy, I just hope that they realize that it's more than just a ball player. a great ball player. It's a great person. Somebody who was humble in all of his accomplishments, and somebody who showed class and dignity and character while capturing the hearts of an entire city. So I can go on, and I won't, but I'll say this to you on behalf of everybody here today, and I mean this from the bottom of my heart. I hope today that your heart was filled with half of the amount of joy that you've given us over the years. You're a Hall of Famer on the field, and you're a Hall of Famer off the field. And I want you to know that the committee loves you, these fans love you, and the entire city of Cleveland loves you. And while the back of your jersey may show the number 6, in the eyes of all your fans, wherever they might be, you're always number 1. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you, Joe. Two other committee members want to do a salute to Mark Page. Mark, stand up. Anthony Delguide, where are you, Anthony? There you are. Thank you, guys, two of our committee members. Before we get on to the event at hand, we're going to have a 7th-inning stretch. So, again, I may ask you to rise if you can and take off your caps as we join Rainey Austin in the singing of God Bless America.
God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside you and guide you through the night with a light from above. Thank you.
1933 in the Bronx, there were two things that formed the foundation of Rocky's love affair with the game of baseball. One, he had two older brothers, Dominic and Vito, who were good ball players themselves, but more importantly, two older brothers let the young brother tag along to the ball fields that were just down the street from where they lived. And where the ball fields were located, Cretona Park in the Bronx. A park that had five baseball diamonds and was just around the corner from where the Colavitos lived. Cretona Park was Rocky's second home, although I think he probably feels Cretona Park was your first home, where you were every day. A little bit of trivia as the neighborhood changed. Another Indian slugger came out of that Cretona Park by the name of Manny Ramirez in the Bronx. As a youngster, Rocky worked hard at his conditioning. One of the things he was most proud of, playing in almost every game, every season. He would run around the baseball field in the winter with combat boots on. He believed that raw, powerful swing of his was generated from his legs. And his forearms, always, ever present, was a handball in his pocket that he would squeeze constantly to get those forearms in powerful swing. Rocky's popularity was evident all over Northeast Ohio, especially on the sandlots where every one of us little leaguers in Northeast Ohio imitated four things that you did on the ball field, Rocky. First, always, you sprint from the dugout to your position in the outfield, and then you sprint back when the third out was made, back into the dugout. All of us on the baseball diamonds sprinted out of the dugout and back to the dugout because of you. Second, third, and fourth were his batting routine. First and foremost, we all imitated how you would kneel in the end of that circle, first and foremost. Then you would stretch the bat over your shoulders. And once you got into the batter's box, what did you do? You pointed the bat at the pitcher. Your routine was our routine. Every kid growing up in that generation had those three batting items in their routine. Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time to hear from our guest of honor today, the one and only Rocco Domenico Colavito. First of all, I just made some little notes. It would be real good if I could find it. There we go. You know he's going to help me with you out. Thanks, President. Yeah. I've never been fond of real long speeches. So you can bet your students, you know, that this is really long. But it's sincere as it can be. Freedom. Without a doubt,
You know, if you're Italian, you're just saying, you know, you're going to get it. And also we will bring my favorite story in this whole world. I'm happy that God chose me to play an instrument. I'm honored and overwhelmed by the presence of each and every one of you. So many of my old friends and many, and David Benning and many others to go out of Foxy, Ivan Frank, and Abby DiBiagio, whom I've known forever. And last but not least, my wife Carmen, who has put up with me. For 67 years. It's so wonderful to see such a turnout as this. I'm actually astonished with this turnout, okay? At the book signing last July, the 2 years. A few years, July 5th, there must have been 800 people on the line. And my friend Mark Summer, and we became great friends once in a while, and then a soccer one or two when we got out of the line. Anyway, he comes up to me and he says, "Rocky, we got to move this line along, but we're going to do this." And I said to him, "Mark, and I know you remember this," I said, "I don't care if you're here all night." I said, "There's nobody going to go home unhappy, okay? Not after this time." From the bottom of my heart, I really do. I want you all to know that I'll do what I can, and I'm here. And thank you immensely for coming out here today. You're wonderful fans, no better fans in this country. And I play for six different teams, so I have an idea. I really shouldn't have been. I should have been there the whole time. I love you all. And thanks again for coming.
Rocky Colavito! Okay, we're getting close to the unveiling. But first, we want to hear from Father Joe Prevett from the neighborhood who is going to bless this park.
Thank you, Emily. 88 years ago, God blessed us with the gift of Rocco Domenico Colavito. And Rocco, you've been a great blessing to us, to all of us who are here today, to the Virgin Islands, and to all of your fans who come here to celebrate. And so now we'd like to give you a blessing on your 88th birthday. Let's listen to the word of the Apostle Paul. "I give thanks to my God of every remembrance of you, praying always with joy in my every prayer for all of you, because of your partnership with the gospel from the first day until now. I am confident of this, that the one who began a good work in you will continue to complete it until the day of Christ Jesus. And so, God of all creation, we offer you grateful praise for the gift of life.
David Clarence of Rocky, your servant, who recalls today the day of birth, and rejoice in your gifts of life and love, family, and friends. Blessed with your presence, surrounded with your love, that he may enjoy many happy years, all in pleasing to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now as we extend to the heart with this new place of honor, let's pray and blessing. And we sing your praises without ceasing, Lord. You rule over all things with wonder and order. You temper the cares and burdens of our toil. And by giving us rest and healthy recreation, you refresh our weary bodies and minds. We entreat your kindness that this place and its facilities will continue to lead your activities that renew the spirit and strengthen mind and body. Grant that all who meet here may find the enrichment of companionship and together offer you the praise that is your due. We ask this in Christ our Lord. Amen. May God who brings light to our minds, strength to our bodies, guide us in all we do, so that each day we may find gladness and friendship. And Rocky, bless you all of us to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. It is now time to unveil the statue. As we get the Colavito family in position to help with that, give us a big round of applause to the artist who created the statue, the same man who has done Larry Gilby, Lou Boudreau, Jim Comey at Progressive Field. Please result, Dave Deming. Now, as they're all getting in place to do the unveiling, hold on, David. I think we heard that today is somebody's birthday. It's 88th birthday. So let's sing happy birthday to Rocky Colavito. Here we go.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Rocky. Happy birthday to you.
We're in position, family, Carmen, we're all good. Okay, everybody, we're going to do all this together. A countdown in unison. And we're going to start, of course, at number six. Uniform number six. So here we go. Six,
five, four, three, two, one.
Congratulations to the entire Colavito family. The city of Cleveland loves you. Ladies and gentlemen, one more round of applause. Generational hero, a Cleveland icon, a giant on the field, Rocco Domenico Colavito. You one favor. We want to get Rocky some wonderful photos and video with his family in front of the statue. So ask you to please remain where you are. You'll get your chance to come up and take a photo. We're not going to be able to do autographs, but we'll be able to do some photos. But first, let the family have an opportunity to get the shots they need. So if you could stay in place, we would appreciate that very kindly. Have a wonderful day, everybody.
With 42.